Ladies and gentlemen, the judges for the second semi-final in the women's 51 kilogram fly competition are number one, the Russian Federation, two, Brazil, three, Uzbekistan, four, Cuba, five, Sweden. The referee is David Lorado from the United States of America. The boxers come to us from India and Great Britain, so please give them a warm welcome as they enter the arena.
Approaching the boxing ring, wearing red, representing India, striding confidently ahead of this, her third bout in the Olympic tournament, is Mery. Just a half smile, a trace of a smile across those lips as she makes her way purposefully towards the Olympic stage. She may only stand 5 foot 2.5 tall, but she is an absolute giant of women's boxing, a real trailblazer, and her opponent is the home boxer. And just look at the ovation that she's receiving as she enters the XL Arena in London. It is Great Britain's Nicola Adams, the reigning European champion, the reigning silver medalist from the World Championships, a three-time World Championship silver medalist overall. And she is preparing to compete here in the Olympic 51 kilogram flyweight semi-final. The winner will progress through to the gold medal bout.
Presenting the boxers, and in the green corner, representing India, the world number four, Mery.
So Nicola Adams raised her right fist in triumph after her announcement from the stadium announcer. And that introduction received a rapturous round of applause from the capacity crowd on hand here at XL South Arena 2, the venue for the Olympic boxing tournament. And this, a battle between two familiar rivals, where the winner will progress through to the gold medal bout. So here we go then, the first of a scheduled 4 2-minute rounds in this women's 51 kilogram flyweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, boxing out of the southpaw stance, representing India, the diminutive figure of Mery, a five-time World Championship gold medalist, and her opponent, representing Great Britain, boxing out of the orthodox stance, wearing blue, is Nicola Adams from Leeds. And I say that these two boxers are familiar rivals. They met at the quarter-final stage of the most recent World Championships in China. On that occasion, it was Nicola Adams who prevailed by the slimmest of margins, just 13 points to 11 in her favor, en route to that World Championship silver medal. And Lucy O'Connor, how significant will that result be in the minds of both of these boxers as Adams just launches an attack and Mery raises her glove to get some adjustment to that head guard?
Yeah, Adams is going to go here into this bout full of confidence after that earlier World Championship result. But Mery has had the experience. She's a 5 times World Championship gold medalist. She has the confidence and she has the experience not to let her phase that too much. She'll approach this bout as she would approach any other bout.
Those championship medals that Mery has acquired over the course of what is a glittering career go all the way back to the inaugural Women's Amateur Boxing Championships in 2001. She got a silver there, gold ever since when she's made the podium. As Adams just launched a good attack a few moments ago, but she got all of that success down at a lower weight, so she's the naturally smaller boxer. That came down at 46 kilograms, her success on the World Championship stage, here having to move up as there are just 3 weight classes being contested in the Women's Olympic Boxing Tournament. This is for the smallest boxers out there, 51 kilogram flyweight division.
Yeah, the both of these boxers in the early half of this round just engaging a few clinches just to try and assert their strength and dominance over each other, keeping themselves out of the way of any incoming punches.
Nicola Adams is the number two seed in this competition. By virtue of that, she had a bye in the opening round before producing a really comprehensive performance in her second bout, prevailing by a score of 16-7 over her opponent from Bulgaria. And as the bell sounds to bring about an end to the first round of this women's 51 kilogram flyweight semi-final, it is the home boxer, Nicola Adams, who leads by 2, 3-1 in favor of Adams. Let's listen in.
What's that mean? You're not quick enough with your rear hand as a counter. You have to counter better with your rear hand. Because as she's coming in, you're not catching her as she's coming in. All right? You need to get your front foot that little bit closer.
Dave Alloway there, just saying that she just needs to be quicker with that backhand. She caught Mery very effectively. When she waited for her to rush at her, she took a half step back through the 1-2, which landed beautifully, clean shot. She needs to just continue to do that, wait for her to come, take a step, half a step back, half a step to the side, and land that backhand.
Into the second round we go. It is scheduled for 4 2-minute rounds in this women's 51 kilogram flyweight semi-final. The winner will progress through to the gold medal bout, and Adams starts brightly with a good right cross out of that orthodox stance. Cheers of GB, GB ringing out here at the XL Arena in London. It's another sellout session here in the 22nd session of Olympic boxing, and the atmosphere has been absolutely electric on hand once again.
Yeah, Adams will thrive on this challenge. 5 times world champion, will not faze her. She's been coached for much of her career by the world-class coach Alwyn Belcher, who has over 50 years boxing experience and certainly has contributed to her performance to date, and has almost certainly contributed to the fact that she has such superior footwork.
Nicola Adams admires Olympic heroes Sugar Ray Leonard and Muhammad Ali. Of course, they rose to prominence, first captured the world's attention here in the Olympic boxing ring. Wonderful that women now able to compete on the same stage as we move into the second half of this second round. Nicola Adams, who began boxing at an after-school club up in Leeds, where her mom went to an aerobics class, a boxing class was taking place. She wandered in, found a natural talent for it, but really struggled to get bouts as a junior. And it wasn't until she entered the senior ranks, 29 years of age now, but it wasn't until she entered the senior ranks that she could compete more regularly against other women in the boxing ring. Good left hand scored by Adams as the two boxers fall into a rather untidy tangle close to the neutral corner on this near side of the ring to our commentary position.
It seems that Mery is just struggling to find a way around Nikki's speed here. Nikki seems to grow with confidence as this bout progresses. And we'll see, I'm sure, if Adams continues to keep the lead, we'll see her shoulders drop, her arms drop, and her flair coming through.
Well, it was a 2-point advantage at the end of the first round. The cheer here in the XL Arena is because Adams has extended it to 3. She leads by 5-2 after 2 rounds of boxing. Dave Alloway providing the instructions once more, but it was straight punching like that, which you perhaps suspect allowed Adams to eke out that advantage to a further 1 point.
We saw some tremendous shots just then by Adams. And a response by Mery, but more of a cuffing shot. Lovely uppercut there by Adams. Dave Alloway in the corner there, just saying she doesn't need to move out quite so far before she comes back.
Both boxers up off their stools, ready for work to begin round number 3. It is scheduled for 4 2-minute rounds in this women's 51 kilogram flyweight semi-final. A place in the gold medal bout is what awaits the victor, as Adams just takes advantage of Calm losing her balance and fired away with a quick-fisted flurry. Beautiful right cross followed a left jab from Adams as we approach 30 seconds elapsed here in the third round. And Adams really using her advantage in height and reach to good effect. Mery Kom, despite her colossal achievement in the boxing ring, is often at a considerable size disadvantage up here in the 51 kilogram flyweight division. But she, in her opening two bouts, she used her speed to tremendous effect to launch raiding attacks as she gets caught by a left-right combination once more and is pinned to the ropes by Adams, who's scoring effectively with both the left and the right hand, putting Kom under serious pressure.
This is fantastic by Adams. She's landing with stronger and stronger shots now as she grows in confidence, catching Mery Kom on the ropes, forcing Mery Kom to dive in so uncharacteristically for her. It just shows how clever a boxer Adams is, causing Mery Kom an awful lot of problems.
So just warned by the official for the entanglement at close quarters with Nicola Adams. As we approach the final 30 seconds of this third round, Kom continuing to try to find a way inside the really long reach that Nicola Adams possesses, a fantastic reach that she possesses as she switches to the southpaw stance. She boxes adeptly out of either stance and does switch feet on a regular basis, just causing further confusion to Mery Kom, who will have seen it all before, of course, but just giving her a different look in these closing seconds.
Yeah, she will have seen it all before, but she will not have had these problems with very many boxers in the past. She seems a little bit baffled. She's got to change her tactics now. She needs to push forward towards Adams, put her back to the ropes.
And with one round of boxing to go, Nicola Adams has extended her advantage to four. It was 2 points after round one, 3 points after round two. It now stands at 8 points to four in favor of Adams.
We see him, Adams driving Mery Kom back to the ropes. Beautiful left hand, right hand there. Practically running towards Mery Kom as she retreats towards the corner.
And there are two familiar faces in the crowd. Prime Minister David Cameron, alongside him, the Olympic silver medalist from Athens 4 years ago as part of a one-man British boxing team, Amir Khan. How things have changed in those intervening 8 years, and how crucial was his silver medal success in keeping that funding going for GB boxing, which is here as part of a 10-strong team in London 2012. Seven men, but three women. Nicola Adams, the last British woman standing in the Olympic boxing tournament, as we move into the fourth and final round of this women's 51 kilogram flyweight semi-final. The winner will progress through to the gold medal bout. And it is Adams who has been in complete control throughout this contest against the iconic Indian boxer Mery Kom, a five-time world championship gold medalist, but she has really struggled to cope with the speed and movement and superior size that Nicola Adams possesses.
Well, Adams continuing to exert her authority over Mery Kom here, scoring with straight shots, just simple boxing, Ron. That's all you need, just simple boxing, straight shots predominantly. Mery Kom did catch her with a nice rear hand as she came in, but Adams attacking with combinations.
Bought of a round of applause from the crowd, but Kom, you suspect, covered up to repel those shots with her gloves. Good left, right by Mery Kom, and Nicola Adams cannot afford to switch off. Her lead is 4 points, but concentration going to be absolutely crucial in this final 40 seconds of this bout. She's being encouraged by the crowd once more. It's at close quarters, and a referee allowing the boxers to work away on the inside.
Adams did well there to get out of the clinch. She needs to be careful not to become lackadaisical. She cannot afford to allow Mery Kom the gaps.
Good left hand by Adams, as Kom just striking Adams on the back of the head as she turned around. That, of course, an illegal blow, but it's also an infringement to turn your back on the opponent. So inside these closing seconds, Nicola Adams, who scores with a snaking left jab, is just moments away from a place in the gold medal bout. Mery Kom continuing to compete until the very final bell, but one suspects she hasn't done enough. A brief glimpse of the alley shuffle from Adams, and that perhaps in recognition that she has done enough to book her place in the Olympic gold medal bout here at London 2012. absolutely beaming from ear to ear as she returned to the blue corner. She led by 4 points coming into this fourth and final round. And even though Mery competed in spirited fashion, one suspects that she hasn't done enough to overturn what was a significant advantage in favour of Adams.
Well, Adams just shows, it just illustrates what a talent Nicola Adams is from Great Britain. She really puzzled Mery right from the first bell, and she struggled, the Indian boxer, to find her way around Adams' speed and her footwork.
So the boxers will be replaying the bout in their minds. A pensive bite of the lip for Nicola Adams. One suspects that she senses she's done enough. But will it be made official? Here comes the announcement. Nicola Adams points proudly to the lion that sits above the Olympic rings on her left breast as she moves into the gold medal bout in the women's 51 kilogram flyweight final. A well-deserved bow to all sides of this capacity-filled XL Arena who played their part in spurring her on to victory. A handshake from her coach Dave Alloway. And now she will have her eye on top spot of the Olympic medal rostrum, having booked her place in the final. There's more work to do, and her opponent in that final is the number one seed, Ren Can Can.